So all of the emotions that may happen in response to errors on the part of clinicians can be resolved. Sometimes they fade away. And I want to be clear, I'm not advocating, I don't think anyone is, for our not feeling negative emotions after we've inadvertently harmed patients. I mean, of course, we care, we're compassionate, of course, there's going to be some suffering. But the problem is, in many cases, we don't heal from that. Sometimes we do, and time can be healing, but there are many, many examples of, and the research supports this, data that shows that people really can experience long-term negative consequences. So, for example, we know that burnout and depression are independent predictors of having made a recent major medical error. We know that if you are burnt out, you have a higher chance of making a medical error. And if you make a medical error, you have a higher chance of being burnt out. There's data about loss of confidence, disruption to collegial relationships, fears about one's ability to practice, hypervigilance, you know, all sorts of reactions to an event that may have happened even years ago, and people really still have this fallout. And very, very disturbingly, there was a physician study that showed that physicians involved in errors had a higher incidence of suicidal ideation. So you can see there's some potentially really devastating consequences for individuals. And then, of course, those can impact patient care. Another consequence of these, the emotional fallout, is how we end up communicating with patients. I think we know that we have issues in our ability to be transparent and compassionate with patients and families after harm events. And I think the emotions that we just talked about are the things that get in the way of our being the kind of healthcare provider that we should be after these times. And so I really do believe that we need to help clinicians manage the emotions in service both of course of their own well-being, but really especially in terms of how we interact with patients.